Today, we're going to look at how to align an image with CSS on a web page. But before we start, please like and subscribe. If HTML is about giving the website a framework, then CSS is the language that concentrates on adding features to the underlying framework, allowing the website to become more visually appealing. This is why, through CSS, we're going to look at the different ways we can add style and align images on a website. Right, so let's look at an example of how to center an image on a web page. I have a basic construct here with an image and a container around it and two classes that I can use to arrange this image. So first, I'm just going to apply some basic styles. I'm going to apply a border. So I'm just going to say border. I'm going to the thickness, 1 pixel. I want it to be a solid line and black. And as you can see, it draws a border around it, and I'm going to give it a width and a height. So I'm just going to say width of 150. And as you can see, it resizes it and the height of 50 pixels, which kind of skews it a bit, but yeah, that's just how it works. Right, now I'm just going to change it to 80, and it looks a bit better now. So the first way of centering an image that I'm going to show you is how to use the margins. So for that, I'm just going to apply the display property first, and make it a block, and then apply left and right margins of auto. I'm just going to say margin left auto, which moves it to the right, and then margin left auto, which moves it into the middle. Very good. So then you can also align content using the text align property, which is used on the container. So I'm just gonna remove this for now. It moves it back to the left, but then if you say text align right, for example, you can see that it moves it to the right, or if I say left again, it moves it to the left. So that's another way how to align your image. Then you can also use the float property. So that's again on the image itself. So if I say float right, for example, again, moves it to the right. And if I change it back to float left, moves it to the left again. So, and the last way of adjusting or aligning your image is actually using the image as a background image. So I'm going to just remove the image from the container. Before that, I'm just going to copy the path so I have it. So yeah, I can just remove the image and then add as a background to container. Actually, I'm going to remove the float property as well. So I'm just going to say background image is URL. I'm going to paste as here. And as you can see, you can't see it yet because what we have to do is apply a width and a height as well. So I'm just going to copy these two attributes from down here. I'm just going to say this. And I want actually the width to be 100%. The height, I'm going to leave it 80 pixels. And as you can see, this actually repeats it now over the page. So what I can say is that it shouldn't repeat. So I'm just going to say background repeat is no repeat. It only has like one image now, but it's still kind of cut off. So what I can say is give it a background size in this instance. And it can say contain, which will then size the image to be contained within the width and the height that you've set. And I can position it as well. So I can say background position and center it, for example, which will center your image. Great. So now you've got four different ways of how to align your image on a web page. We hope you learned something new about front-end development to improve the appearance of websites. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and if you want to learn more about coding for free, please find a link to a 5-day coding challenge in the description below.